Hey everybody, going to do a little video of Butterbean getting his dinner here. I just threw a bunch of snails in there, and he knows they're in there. I think some of them floated on the surface, because I did see him munching on something, and some little bits of shell were falling to the bottom when I picked the camera up. But now he's found the ones down there on the bottom. So the upshot to having little shrimp in this tank and little bumblebee gobies is that I don't often have to feed them specifically. Butterbean is such a messy eater, all puffers are, that there will simply be enough little bits and pieces of food left over around the tank that the shrimp and the little bumblebee gobies will be able to just live off of his leftovers and his little leavings. Now the sailfin mollies are a little bit of a different story. They actually do need to get some real fish food put in the tank occasionally for them. And of course, likewise, they don't eat all of it, and any that gets to the bottom is, you know, eaten up by the shrimp and the gobies. I wonder what he's doing. I'm guessing that's a shrimp, I mean a snail right there that he wants, but it must not be facing the right direction for him to get to. You think he would just pick it up and eat it. He's gonna come back for it. I threw five or six snails in there, so there's plenty of other snails for him to look around, although we have seen him get a few of them already. Still showing no signs of any interest in going after the shrimp. And the other day I shot a video about him being sort of stressed out by the mollies being in there, and I could see that one of the mollies was sort of harassing him. I have looked and looked and looked, and I've not seen that behavior since then. He's been acting perfectly normal. I see him interacting around the other fish. They don't seem to bother him when they swim near him. He doesn't, you know, swim away from them anymore. So perhaps it was just getting used to the new fish being in the tank for a few days. Perhaps it was just sort of a, you know, everybody gets on somebody's nerves sometimes, and maybe I just happened to be there at that moment that he was just not in the mood to be bothered by that other fish. But since then, I haven't seen anything that makes me really concerned about getting those mollies out of this tank in any kind of hurry. I think he's going to be just fine. I don't think I have too much to worry about. But I do have my eye on it. It is always an option if those mollies do become too annoying to him. And I notice that he is spending most of his time stressed out and his color's all grayed out and he just seems, you know, unhappy in general. I can always move them out of here and put them in a different tank. I have plenty of room for them in, you know, other tanks. Mollies are certainly, you know, friendly enough that they can go in most tanks as long as there's nothing in there that's going to eat them. They're certainly not going to eat anything else. Not really sure what he's finding down there. Maybe he's picking up little bits of shell. I did get him back on his normal freeze-dried krill. For several days he had just been off of that, and it would float around in the tank until it eventually sank. And I didn't worry too much about it because I would see the mollies pecking at it, the gobies would peck at it, and then of course the shrimp in the tank would eat it. And so it always would get eaten up. But Butterbean himself was not doing a whole lot as far as eating the freeze-dried krill. And again, I was worried that maybe it was because of these orange mollies right there. That's one of them. You know, it was stressing him out, and the stress was causing him to get off of his food and all that. And it might have been, as I said, for a few days until he sort of adjusted. But earlier today I fed him some freeze-dried krill and he ate it without any problem at all. In fact, he was kind of pacing the glass waiting for me to open the lid and drop some food in, just like he used to. So he's kind of recovered. He's sort of snapped back from having the new tank mates in there. I think that was a little bit of a disturbance to him, but now that he's gotten used to him, I don't think we're going to have anything to worry about. So I'm going to call that good. Not really sure why he seems to be so fidgety tonight. He's pacing the glass quite a bit. Normally when there's food in the tank, he is just right on it and he zeroes in on it until it's gone. But as I said, I did feed him earlier, so perhaps he's not all that terribly hungry at the moment, which is unusual in itself for puffers. They eat like little piggies and they will eat and eat and eat. You actually have to be careful how much you feed puffers because they can very easily overeat. With their elastic bodies, they can just keep expanding and expanding and expanding, and that's not good for them. So he's tucked away back up there in the corner somewhere. There he comes. So I'm going to say thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Make sure you subscribe. That way you won't miss anything I got coming up. You never know what it's going to be with me. And then don't forget, of course, this one is my brackish tank. So thanks again for watching, and I will see you real soon on the next one.